Don't kick over our turkey.
I'm gonna kick. Hi, this is Francis. And this is Tomato. Just wanted to give you guys another video blog. Everything that follows after this can be photos and videos that we've taken over the last week or so. Welcome to the war.
Tell a story.
Which story?
If you don't tell a story, I'm gonna tell a story.
Which story? The dicks?
No. No. The Huey ride.
Oh, jeez.
Ooh, I want to tell it.
All right.
It's like 15 seconds of intro and 40 seconds of us arguing.
We can cut it. Go ahead. It's still recording.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, so this was the thing. We took a trip down to Soto, where we drove for like 2 hours, and they decided to give us a flight back up here. And they're like, oh, yeah, you're going to be flying in helicopters, which are actually Hueys. So, immediately we both thought, shit, we're going to be in. But anyway, so we get up past that point, and it was actually civilians. So we're sitting on these Hueys. No window. We're like basically 3 inches away from falling out of this plane.
And we're kind of scrunched in.
Yeah, we are scrunched in. We're not playing helicopter. We're really scrunched together, all tight and stuff. Sergeant Horton decides he wants to get something out of his pocket. So he reaches in, shifts his weight slightly, and breaks the seat rod. Snap. Now the entire rest of the flight, we all got to sit like this. It was hilarious. You should have been there.
Do it. Don't be a pussy. Hold on.
Hey, do you want us to document how come you only have one ear plug in right now? Let's tell the story real quick.
So you can imagine that in this full getup, it's very difficult sometimes to eat. So I went to the train and I was moving things around and I dropped an ear plug in the toilet. So, we're going to end up finding out if, number one, I can get new earplugs. One.
He only has one.
Either going to see if I can get new earplugs, or I'm going to see if my noise-canceling headphones are as good as they say.
Or he'll sit the entire trip like this.
Too many skills.
This is Sergeant Horton juggling circus balls in full body armor right before we get on the Chinook and or Blackhawk.
Screw you. Alright, here we are back at the Chew. The Graves. Pretending to work, I'm sure. What are you working on, Graves?
Doing actual work. I'm trying to get a website going called www.don'tdisrespecttheiraqicolonel.com. Only problem is I don't have like a lead story for it. This idea just popped in my head randomly. I just need like an actual event to plug into this website. All right. I'm gonna get it going. Can you fill me in on that?
Yeah, so let's please document how I'm losing the hearts and minds of the Iraqis.
You did it.
Come here. You're gonna hold the camera, I'm gonna be on camera for this one. Alright. Joe. We go to talk to this colonel, this Iraqi police colonel. Now, it's been a while since I've been in a foreign land like
this. Sure, let's blame it on time.
it's been a while, and I usually pride myself on being fairly cognizant of local traditions and things like that. You know, obviously, I'm not going to run around and ogle their women. I mean, they're wearing headscarves anyway. But yeah, you try to be nice. Now, they gave us this class on all these things that you're not supposed to do because it's like a big middle finger to the Iraqis. One of them is this symbol, which to us means okay, but to them means you're an asshole. Now, I forget that showing the bottom of your shoe to an Iraqi is a big no-no. And I figured at this point, people here would kind of figure, you know, They know that we're not trying to disrespect them, right? Apparently not, because I'm sitting there at this meeting taking notes. I put my leg up on my knee so that I could take some notes, and suddenly the room goes silent, and and the interpreter just looks at me and is like, "Sir, can you please put your foot down?"
Boom.
I have never dropped a foot faster. Because this colonel is like, he's not even making eye contact with me. He doesn't even want anything to deal with me. And now I'm just thinking, fuck, I'm going to get shot as soon as I leave here.
Because you disrespected the colonel.
I disrespected a colonel. I basically just went up and slapped the colonel in the face.
Nice. Now, can you demonstrate over here on your bunk exactly how you were sitting for the people at home?
Just so everybody can understand what an innocuous gesture this is. I'm sitting here taking notes, and I'm like, wow, this is hard. Where's my notepad? Where's my notepad? Taking notes, I'm like, wow, sure could use a table, so I do like this. This is it. This is all I do. But he's sitting over there. Bottom of the foot. So, expect this war to go on another 5 years.
In a fight at Gumby, on a hippie trailhead full of zombies, I met a strange lady. She made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under, where women go and men wonder? Can't you hear the thunder? You gotta take cover. Buying bread from a man in Brussels. He was 6'4" and full of muscle. I said, do you speak my language? He just smiled and gave me a Vegemite sandwich. And he said, I come from a land down under, where it does flow and mention her. Can't you hear the thunder? You better run, you better take cover.
I've got. All right.